Well, it's been an absence of more than 10 days, which is an extraordinarily long time for a leader who is so prevalent on the Russian media. The conversation here is dominated by his actions and what he does, so you very rarely don't see him. So it's been 10 days and it wasn't explained. But finally, Russian state television has come out, broadcast these pictures, it broadcast them live, of Vladimir Putin meeting his counterpart from Kyrgyzstan in St. Petersburg. He looked very well. No sign of any illness that would have explained his absence for so long. But that absence has sparked all sorts of rumours, not least that he was ill. There was speculation he'd got cancer and he was recovering from that or being treated for that. Speculation he'd suffered a stroke, that it hurt his back, that he'd got flu. All along, the Kremlin categorically denied that he was ill, saying that he was in perfect health. Another strand of the speculation was that he wasn't even in the country, that he'd travelled elsewhere, to Switzerland, in fact, to witness the birth of his love child. That, of course, was not confirmed by the Kremlin, because Vladimir Putin, for one reason, keeps details of his personal life under very tight wraps indeed. And so we're still none the wiser about that. A third strand, though, of rumour, of speculation, was that there are internal machinations taking place in Russia, and that Vladimir Putin had been ousted in some kind of palace coup and that he was no longer in charge. And so this appearance going some way to put pay to that speculation as well. He still seems very much to be the president of Russia. For his part, he seemed his usual self. He even made light of the fact he'd been absent. He didn't explain it, but he said, look, you know, the world would be a very boring place if it weren't for gossip. Matthew Chance, CNN Moscow.